Hello everyone, this is our first video. It will be the introduction for our tool, myfractalrange.com. I want to thank everyone who decided to join in May in order to discover this tool. Every feedback you are doing is being monitored and registered. We are working on them to improve the website. Some bugs we were already aware, and some bugs that you guys have found are actually things we didn't notice before. All of them are being worked on currently. So you will see the tool evolve every day, every week, to take into account every feedback you have given to us. So this one is the page with the portfolio. This is basically the portfolio you currently have. It will display the ticker name of the asset you are looking at. You've got the last price. The last price, for example, one bug here is that it's the previous close. It should be the current price. This will be fixed. The lower and upper fractal ranges, they are the most probable place where the stock will go based on the previous close. As of now, you cannot update it intraday. We are testing this solution. Our admins have this access, but it has not been released yet. So it will come soon. You've got the downside. So this is the difference between the lower range and the last price. The problem is, because it's based on the previous close, the downside and upside are not accurate. So it should be based on the current price. We are working on this. So I would suggest for the moment you focus on these two when making the decision to take a position. Then you've got the upside to downside. So it's the ratio between both. The higher it is, the most confident you can be when taking a position. The 30-day higher high, lower low. So basically, green means the asset is doing a higher high on the 30 days looking back period. Lower low, it's red. So it means the asset is doing lower low on 30-day looking back period. And yellow means it's doing neither. You've got the trend, green being bullish, yellow being neutral, red being bearish. You can delete an asset. You can add one here. So let's add again Apple. Okay, so you've got that covered. You can add some foreign asset. For example, I'm gonna add one French ticker. So you can see dot expar is the suffix given by our data provider. So each foreign market has its own suffix. You can find the link in FAQ. I think it's marketstack.com/search. Then you input the ticker or the name of the asset you are looking for, and it will tell you what is the suffix you need to use. So this one is French. Okay, it's Paris. Okay, so it's working. It's loading. We have noticed that some foreign markets are currently not working. The ones working for sure are Toronto, all the Euronext ones, so Paris, Germany, London, and Amsterdam, for instance. We know that Japan and Australia are not working anymore. We are checking to find another market provider, market data provider for these ones. You can ask for example, bonds and some of the foreign exchange. So for example, you have dollar here. You have the VIX and the VXN here. But you cannot input like Euro, USD, or this, for example, I don't know, like GPI, USD. You know, you need to go through an American ETF to get it. So for example, let me try one. Let's try fixer. Okay, so you can get it. But you cannot get the pair. If I try to do like Euro USD, I don't think it's gonna work. You can see it's not working. Okay, so for now, when there is a bug in the ticker, it's just an infinite loop. We will add a message, you know, to say, yeah, it's not working. Every time I ask for a ticker, it's gonna use some of my credit. So for example, I have a 100 ticker package per month, and it's being, every time I ask for one, it's being used. There is a bug currently that if you ask for one, but it's not working, it will be counted. This will be fixed soon, and all the credit used for tickers that didn't work will be given back to you. So you don't need to worry about that. Another question was also, are the tickers given for free counted in my count? It's not. For example, VIX, I know there is some other one. I think there is a SPY, etc. QQQ. These ones are not being counted in your credit. Another feature that we have is a refresh complete list. It will refresh all of them. Okay, let's hope it doesn't bug. Okay, it's working. You've got also the export. So basically you are exporting all the data here. It will be in a CSV format. You can also click on the ticker. So you can see Apple here. You can see on 20 day, 60 day, 180 day, 1 year. You've got the range, you've got the longer term range. The longer term range, it's the look back period is longer. Okay, so basically it's 3 months or more. It's not a fixed amount of days for the look back period because it depends on the volatility. Okay, of course, for range it will change, for longer term range it will change according to the asset and the current volatility trend of the asset. Then you've got a performance table based on previous day, week to day, month to day, quarter to day, year to day. You've got the relative volume, so based on the 20 day average, 40 day average, 60 day average, and you've got the relative performance table in comparison with other assets. I know that you can add several tickers at once, but I have tried it before and I have noticed it's there is a bug on it. So I'm gonna try, let's see. I'm gonna try XLE and XLB. Let's have a look. XLE, comma, XLB. Okay. So I know it's working, but I know that when I input several at once, it's taking more time. So we're gonna go to watch list, keep on navigating the website, and we're gonna come back to this. So I would suggest you do one by one. It's much faster. When you do several at once, we know it's there is a problem. So we are working on this one. We're gonna come back later to watch those. Then we have the watch list. Okay, so the way I use it and the way I would suggest you guys to use it is you can do some sector watch list. So for instance, let's say you have tech. So let's put, for example, I don't know, like Facebook. Let's say, I know it's communication, but let's put it there. You can have which one do you like? TWLO. Okay, for instance. Let's add another one, for example, let's do commodities. Okay, so I add commodities, and I can add USO. I can add, people who requested this one, I think it's uranium. You have wood, so it's lumber. So all of these, you know, can be added in commodities. Okay, and some people have asked if, for example, let's say I put the same ticker in two watch lists, does it count as two? No, it doesn't. If you use one ticker, no matter why you use it, it will be counted only as one. So if, for example, let's say I have wood here in tech, for example, and also in my portfolio, it's still counted as one. But if you delete it, for example, Facebook, I delete from here and I delete from here, it's still being counted. You know, some people have said, I don't understand, I have deleted it from my watch list and from portfolio, but it's still being counted in my profile. Yeah, it's like you go to the movie, you don't like the movie. So in that case, you don't like the range, or maybe you don't like the trend, and you think like, oh yeah, I don't need it anymore. Yeah, but you have seen it. So it's being counted for sure. I mean, some people. So you can refresh the complete list. So very simple. You can change the list name. So I'm not gonna do it, but yeah. You can delete it. Okay, so it was deleted. And you can export the list. Same as as in the other one. You can add Tika, it's the same thing. Then you've got Explorer. So Explorer, we are working on this because some people have mentioned this and I think they are right. It's useful because it's giving you an idea of what's the current market status, but I think it's a bit messy, you know, especially if you are watching a lot of tickers. I mean, in my own account, I watch like 80 tickers from my portfolio, and it's unreadable. It's useful, for example, for some watch list. For instance, if I had, for example, UUP or DXY in this one, it would be interesting to see the correlation between all of them. If I'm not mistaken, the first one on the outside is the trend. The second one here is the higher high or lower low. And then the link between an asset and another one is a correlation. Okay, so for example, you can see that USO is correlated with wood in a big way, and USO is correlated to Euro in a smaller way. Then what do you have? You have the support. So basically, you have you can send us what you have seen. You need to be very careful about what you are sending us, okay? We will update this message to say that if the answer to your question is already in FAQ, we will not answer it anymore, because we have been submerged with questions that are already in FAQ. We are also updating the FAQ currently, so you will find more information about your feedbacks in there, okay? This will be completed with a lot of answers to your questions. Okay, so this is the way it's working now, and I can maybe give you a look of how it works in my account. So you're gonna go here. So you can see, you know, how it looks when you get the real time data. The market is not open currently, but it will show you how you will get it soon. So we are loading. It takes time because we are checking with our data provider to get the calculation, to get the data to make the calculation. So it takes time sometimes to log in. So let's see what we get. Taking time to compute fractal dimension. So this one is actually my admin. I'm currently testing the real-time data. So I use it to trade currently, you know, and basically what I do is I update update the ticker constantly to see where I'm at. Then I organize upside to downside, and I focus on the ones that are the most interesting in terms of buying. So the problem is right now is most of the interesting tickers, I mean the ones with the most upside to downside, they are bearish. So I just add very very little when they are the low range. You can see, you know, the downside is getting smaller and smaller compared to the upside. So I add to them, but I add very simply. One feature that we are currently working on is the range alert. So basically what we want to do is to give you an alert when an asset maybe change a trend, or when you get to a certain distance from the price gets to a certain distance from the downside or upside. You would have the alert history there. So this is one feature we are working on. So I mean, we are working on this. You should see a lot of new things, you know, appearing every day. But it takes time, guys. Okay, I mean, we've just launched 4 days ago, and we are still 1 month and 3 weeks away from the official launch. So anyway, I hope you liked this introductory video, and please keep sending us some questions in support. Take time to read the FAQ. I mean, it's very important that you do this. And let us know if you have any bugs that we have not noticed yet in the FAQ. Have a good day, guys.